them a smooth entry into the respective field of technology, of healthcare, whatsoever, namely by having small improvements patented, offering them as a currency to the owners, sometimes foreign companies, sometimes more and more also Indian companies, in order to buy the permittance to make this substance, to make this whatever new product which is subject to the dependent patent, and thereby getting them much quicker into a market which otherwise would be closed by the original patents for a longer time, fully, until the expiration of such patents. So my suggestion would simply be that one looks into this problem, which I see here in India, that there is lack of patentability of even small improvements, sometimes small improvements, particularly in the field of pharmaceuticals, but not restricted thereto. And last remark, you might even wish to think about things like a legislator in a country in Europe, which I know very well, namely Germany, has done. We have a specific provision in our patent law. We have, of course, the normal compulsory licensing provisions that you need public interest to get a compulsory license, etc. That's our Article 24.1 of our patent law. Fine, everybody has this more or less fully in conformity with TRIPS. We have an Article 24.2. It says that if you patent an improvement of an important nature, similar wording like this, then you are entitled, as a matter of law, in a license under a superior patent on which you are depend, but that license is a very specific one. It comes at a price. It is given in the form of a cross license. That means a license is given to the owner of the original patent, to the owner of the improvement patent, and they get then into a cross-licensing situation which is not necessarily cost-free for both sides. It can be with an additional cash component. But to have as a legislator, as a court, as a patent office, whatever authority, that possibility to encourage people to cross-license, to make it easier for improvers of patented technologies to enter the otherwise closed market, I think is an idea which, maybe it's my lack of knowledge of Indian patent law, I could not find yet in the Indian patent law, in any rules of practice. It is the normal TRIPS conform, of course, compulsory licensing possibility, but not this encouraging possibility which the law creates. And it might be a consideration also for the sharing friendly Indian society economy, namely to use patents as vehicles for technology transfer, particularly to look into this necessity to create entry possibilities for small and medium-sized enterprises into a highly patented world. Having said this, I'm very much looking forward to first the further progress of this conference today, and I'm already now looking forward to the 10th CIPC next year, hopefully taking place somewhere in India, and I would be happy to participate again. Thank you so much.